So let's take a look at what you've written.
Okay. I am angry at Bill because he had an affair and separated and divided our family.
So he had an affair, is that true?
Yes.
He had an affair?
Yes.
Okay, so in this moment now, can you absolutely know that it's true?
I still have to say yes.
Good. And how do you react? Let's say you're sitting in your favorite chair at home. Kids are at school. It's a perfect moment. You're looking out the window. You can see this wonderful sky, flowers maybe. And you're sitting there, and it's just, you're so full of gratitude and comfortable. And all of a sudden, the thought hits, he had an affair.
Yeah, it triggers my insecurities. Makes me uncomfortable.
So how do you react? Describe it. How do you react when you think the thought, he had an affair, and you're sitting in your favorite chair at home, and all is right with the world?
Right. It destroys the good things.
So describe it. Describe the feelings that happen when you think the thought.
Oh, it's just this internal pain. And
describe it. Where is it? Where does it start?
It's in my stomach.
Yeah.
And now, I want to flee.
And follow those feelings. How much of your body? Notice how much it hits you in the stomach, and notice how much of your body as you sit in that chair and you think the thought.
I'm really tight, very stressed.
And what images do you see when you think the thought he had an affair?
Being alone.
Yeah, so you see a thought of the future.
Yes.
And then you see thoughts of the past. You see images there too. He had an affair. Do you see him with her?
I did. Try not to.
You try not to, and
Or be that visual about it. I try not to be that.
Yes, we all try not to be. And there they are, the past and the future, images. And you witness that, and those feelings, they hit your stomach. Now, in that same situation, sitting in your favorite chair, who would you be without the thought he had an affair?
I would probably feel better about myself.
No, probably. Close your eyes.
I would feel better about myself.
So close your eyes and experience.
I'd be relaxed.
You're in the chair, relaxed.
Yeah, I'd be really relaxed.
Yeah.
I would feel like I was letting go of really something heavy.
So he had an affair with the thought. Your stomach is hit. All those emotions flood you. And without the thought, you're very comfortable. And what's his name, Bill?
Mm-hmm.
So how can Bill be the problem? He's not even in the room.
Yeah, I understand. I'm just resisting. I'm resisting.
Okay.
The reality of it.
Okay, so let's look at it again.
Okay.
With the thought, all of this stress, without the thought, relaxed. So how can the world be your problem? The world is not your problem. What you're believing about the world, that is all the stress you carry. It is all the meanness that ever hit your heart. Was that image him, or was it an image?
It was an image of my future loneliness. So it was less an image of him than it was of myself.
Yeah.
It's true.
Yeah. So
that is true.
So you're not... What was the word? What is the singular for, or the present for, like, infidelity? You're not being what?
Betrayed currently. Well,
you're betraying yourself.
Yeah, that's
you're
true.
In the future all alone when actually you're here right now.
I'm not alone.
Doing perfectly fine.
True. That's very true. I only feel upset when I progress to the future.
So is that an image, or is that you out there alone?
It's an image because it hasn't happened.
Good to know. Good to know the difference. There's the dream, and then there is reality. So you watch the image like you're watching a movie, and then you are stricken with terror.
Mm-hmm.
And then you live your life out of that. You might meet a man and come off as a personality and identity you wouldn't dream of otherwise, because I don't want to be alone. Our relationships are even fearful.
Pardon me?
Our relationships even become fearful.
I can understand that.
Yeah. So Bill had an affair.
Yes.
Turn it around.
I had an affair?
Yes. Yes. So tell me about that.
I wish I had. I don't know. How
well,
does that happen?
Have you ever imagined him with her? I know you try not to.
Yeah, I don't have a problem with that much. More,
well,
it's more...
Well, I didn't, you know... Yes, and have you ever seen the images of him with her?
Of course.
Okay, so you're having an affair. And you're using him and her to do it. You're having an affair in your head. There it is.
Because I'm picturing their affair in my head?
Yeah, you know, it's like...
I'm keeping
like
it current.
Peeping Tom.
I'm keeping it current,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
I also thought, like, I could say I'm betraying myself, my own life, my own...
Yes, yes. Get out of
him
get out of their business and get a life.
Yeah.
You know, like, well, you know, get the life you've already got right here, right now. This is it. You want to see the future? Look, here you are. You've always wanted to see it. Well, notice, you were born to sit. Right here, right now. Not very complicated, is it? Not very complicated at all. You can do this. You can do this. This is all that's required of us until we stand, and you can do that too. It's what we're believing along the way that is counterproductive.
Yes.
You know, our hearts race and our blood pressures fly. And so he had an affair. Can you find another turnaround? He didn't?
He didn't?
Yeah.
That's hard.
Well, you know, give him some credit. There were times when he didn't.
Okay.
Yeah. It's that balance thing. That's right. Yeah. If you believe what he believed, you'd have an affair too.
That's true.
Yeah.
Right. He blamed me, so, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, you know, he believed it. And he's guilty of believing.
Believing his beliefs, yeah. Yes. I see that's true.
Yeah, and he just had to live them out, just mm-hmm. like you have yours. Let's look at the next one.
Along the same line, the second one. I want Bill to realize fully the impact of his behavior on our family, acknowledge our pain.
Is that true? You want him to do all of that?
I want it, but it's not true. I mean, he's not doing it.
Is it true you want him to do that? You want him to acknowledge that? Are you sure? That's the short version of, is it true? Can you absolutely know that it's true? It's like, are you sure?
Well, I don't want him groveling, but I don't know. I mean, I still want him to be
So it's
himself.
A yes or no? It's a
I
yes
guess
or no?
It's not a clear yes. But... That's
okay,
a hard
so,
one.
So, yeah, so let's get back into the work now.
Okay.
You want him to, what was it, realize?
Yeah, realize the impact
you,
of
you
his behavior.
You want him to realize the impact of that.
Mm-hmm.
Is that true?
It feels true.
It's a yes or a no.
I don't know. It's mostly true, I guess. I know, it's hard. That one's hard.
It's a good one to sit with, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, if I had the thought, you know, I want someone to realize the true impact of what they've done, I would really have to consider that.
It's very self-righteous, yeah. It's
well,
right, or judgmental?
Well, yes, but just consider it. Just consider it. For one thing, it's impossible.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. It's not reality.
It's just absolutely impossible.
Because if he did, he wouldn't have done what he did, right?
Well, I would just say that we can't until we can.
So it's not a reality, yeah. So that's why I have
and
to
the more pressure
it.
We get to do it, the more resistance we put up.
Okay.
So, you know, it works that way, too. So, how do you react when you believe this thought? You want him to to fess up to all that, realize all of that, and he doesn't?
I get stuck at a point in my life where I can't move on. I'm waiting for something that's never going to happen, probably.
Good catch.
I mean, if it hasn't happened, it's not real, right?
So your life's on hold.
I put my own life on hold.
So who would you be without the thought, I want him to realize what he's done?
Free. Freer.
Now imagine yourself with him. Maybe he's picking up the kids or something. Without the thought, I want him to realize this.
I would be a more calm and loving person. I would just not have that tightness in myself.
More compassionate?
Yeah. At times I can be compassionate.
So I want him to realize?
I don't want him to...
Read what you've written so okay. We have it straight.
I want him to realize fully the impact of his behavior on our family.
Turned around, I want me.
I want myself. I want to realize how my behavior...
No, just straight up.
Okay.
I want to realize.
I want to realize fully the impact of his behavior.
Of my.
My behavior on my family. I think that's very true. Yeah, I need to start looking at that. Because that I can control.
Yeah.
That I can change.
Any sadness you experience, it's not right or wrong. It's just that you're teaching your children, this is how you're supposed to look when someone leaves you or when someone's not loyal. This is how it looks. And that's not a conscious thing. It's just what we teach. We teach asleepness. It's not right or wrong.
Because sometimes I don't know, because I have daughters, how I should be with that.
Honest, and that's what you're being. That's what you're being. What I can tell you is if my husband, Stephen, had an affair, you know, I love him. Why would I miss it? In other words, honey, my goodness, you know, to be with someone other than me, that must be amazing. You know, tell me. I respect him.
You still respect
him? That went over a few heads.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's all about you changing yours.
Right.
Yeah, because he will or he won't. But
exactly.
There's one person in your family that can. If you are listening to you, then you'll take that into consideration. Let's look at the next one.
Okay, what is it that he should or shouldn't do, be, think, or feel? Bill should be aware of how his dishonesty and sneakiness hurts our family.
So... Bill should be aware of this. Is that true?
That's my opinion.
Bill should be aware of this. Can you absolutely know that it's true? He should be aware of this? You know, this is not a little thing, is it? These people should be more awake to themselves. They should see how they're hurting us. What is the matter with those people? They should. And do they? And when they do, it's not enough. They know, they're holding out.
I so believe that sometimes. He knows what he needs to do, but he won't do it.
Yeah, and you're so sure.
Yeah.
And then how do you react when you believe that? What happens to your relationship with him, your relationship with your children, your relationship with your parents, your world?
It upsets
your addictions,
yeah.
Your feelings. How do you react when you believe the thought he should be more aware?
Like he's not giving me something like that I deserve, so I feel almost unworthy. And I start to feel pain, and I start to feel bad about myself because I'm not worthy enough for him to acknowledge the pain.
So who would you be without the thought that anyone on this entire planet should be more aware of anything?
Free. Just I would be free.
So all of you, consider that. Who would you be without that thought? The people should be more aware of how they hurt you, how they hurt others. And I'm not asking you to drop the thought. I'm just asking you to consider, who would you be living your life without that condition? without placing that condition on us. Notice how you treat us when you believe that thought. Again, victims are violent people. You should be more aware. I'm so wounded. Who would you be without the thought? You should be more aware. So, sweetheart, let's turn it around.
Okay.
I
should be aware of how...
Read it just the way you wrote it.
Okay. Bill should be aware of how his dishonesty and sneakiness hurt our family. I should be aware of how...
My
dishonesty?
Yes. I mean, you are so surprised. I mean, you look just like Bill.
You're right.
The part where he should be able to do it, not me.
I'm being dishonest about who he is. Is that it?
I don't know. You know, I'm doing mine over here.
Okay.
You do Bill, I'll do mine. You know.
Yeah, I think I might be lying to myself.
Might be.
I am. If I'm waiting for something that isn't real or is never going to happen.
As far as you know.
As far as I know, yeah, it's true.
So read it like that again.
I should be aware of how my dishonesty and sneakiness.
Where have you been sneaky with him? And where have you been sneaky with your children? And where have you been sneaky with yourself?
Oh, let's see. That's a little hard for me.
Well, it's a little hard for him, too.
Yeah. How have I been sneaky? I guess I've been sneaky harboring
now
these
drop
thoughts.
I guess.
Okay.
You deserve it all. Where have you been dishonest in your relationship? My goodness, it's just flowing out of me. I'm just getting the most amazing things. You know, my mind is so open. It's exciting. You know, where was I dishonest with Stephen this morning? Where was I sneaky this morning? And maybe not even with Stephen, with myself.
I think that's more what it is. I'm sneaky with myself, or maybe I'm dishonest with myself because I want to believe my story. I mean, I'm dishonest with myself mainly because I want to believe in my story of how things should be, and that's not the reality.
Look, you're putting requirements on him.
Yeah, and then you always lose.
Expecting him to do what you haven't even considered. Maybe he hasn't either.
Mm-hmm.
Have you been dishonest with him?
How have I been dishonest with him? I'm sure I have.
Are you doing yours? Those of you not looking to yourself, where are you being dishonest? Where are you being sneaky in your relationship? You're not getting what you came for if you're not looking to yourself right now. And I don't mean just to this workshop today. You know, the invitation is to get what you came for. You know, yourself back.
I guess I could say I've been sneaky at times during, 23 years of marriage, maybe to try to get something from him, love
so
or manipulation.
Where do all these maybes and I guesses come from? You either or you haven't.
Well, I'm sure in 23 years, I'm sure I have.
You're sure of it? Identify it. This in general stuff is noble. It just doesn't get it. Specifically, where have you been dishonest? Where
sneaky.
Have you been sneaky? Personal work.
There's a lot of things, I guess. I'm sure. Because I'm human.
Well, you're sure, and that won't get it. It's in general. Again, until we identify it, it doesn't change. We have to realize it before it can shift. And sweetheart, it is not easy sitting up here in front of more than 300 people. You're amazing. So this is homework.
Yeah, there's a lot I have to think about the dishonest.
You know, I look back at my life, you know, in relationships, and I blame them. It was all their fault. And when I look back at myself, I don't even have time to think that anymore. I'm so busy naming my own. And as they're identified, my life gets lighter. Enlightenment. It's a beautiful thing to be self-realized, not partner-realized.
Yes.
I mean, we're so clear about them.
Well,
when it comes to us, it's like, well, maybe I've been dishonest. I've been kind of.
I think that goes along with how you say stay out of their business. Right? Why waste your time?
Well, actually,
I don't say
stay out of their business.
I kind of understood that from your book.
Yeah, yeah.
What's their business?
A lot of people understand it that way.
Okay, that's wrong.
But... Well, actually, I don't say stay out of their business. I say if you notice that you are experiencing loneliness or separation, just to notice mentally whose business you're in. And for example, if I'm in my daughter's business and she's in California, I'm in Alaska, and I'm running her life, and she's in California running her life, two of us running her life, and there's no one here for me. I'm like this sleepwalker that is busy in California, you know, as I sit in Alaska. And if you just notice when you feel the separation or loneliness and ask yourself whose business you're in, notice that, it can bring you right back to where you are. And what is so beautiful about being where you are is there's nothing to do. My goodness, I can't run my daughter's life from here. Isn't that a state of grace? You know, it's going to have to be up to her. I don't know how she's going to do it without me. But everything that I am to do is out of right here, right now. That is grace. I don't have to do anything, and I mean, this is it.
Such a unleashing of such a burden if you don't have to do anything.
Yeah, it's just so, and then you might notice that your hand picks up the water, and you know, you do have something to do after all.
But it's a lot lighter. You don't think ahead.
Certainly
right?
Is.
It, when it comes.
You know, when I discovered this, I was trying to identify a time when I had not been running the business of the world or someone's business somewhere. And I couldn't find a moment. And it was amazing just to be here now and have enough respect for the world to understand that, like me, they were doing the best that they could do, and basically, I'm not needed. I'm needed. I need to be right here, right now. How do I know that's true? Here I am.
Right.
So that really works for me. There's never more than I can handle right here, right now. And there's never anything that I need to handle that's not right here, right now.
Yes, if you stay in the present, it's perfect, kind of, I guess.
Yeah, yeah. There's such ease in it.
Yeah, yeah. That's what I'm looking for, mm-hmm. Serenity.
Yeah.
I guess we all are.
So, can you find another turnaround? Read it the way you wrote it again.
Bill should be aware of how his dishonesty and sneakiness hurts.
So, turn it around, he shouldn't.
He shouldn't be aware of how his dishonesty and sneakiness hurts. And... that's true because he isn't.
Yeah, And you know, nothing is ahead of its time.
True.
You know, if he were to, let's say he doesn't realize it, and for all you know, he does. But let's say he doesn't. It's not time.
That's a good way to look at it.
It could throw a person into, you know, just terrible chaos. There's nothing happens ahead of its time.
Right, because it isn't his time.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I can't control that, and I shouldn't even be banging my head against the wall trying to. Yeah.
Because it hurts to bang your head against the wall. and not to is an act of self-love. And when you have the thought he should realize how he has hurt us, you can think in that moment, oh, I should realize how I'm hurting me in this moment in his name.
Yes.
Using his images to hurt me.
It is all images because it isn't his time, obviously. If it was his time, he'd do it. So, yeah. It's true. That's a wonderful way for me to think about it.
Well, you know, it's your time. You wake up to where you have been.
I've wasted so much time with this issue, waiting for him to do something when that's insane.
Well, you know, actually, it costs you your life. And it costs you your relationship with your children's father. And that's not okay with you.
Right.
You know, the next time he comes to the door, you may see him as someone very wise, you know, wise enough not to move ahead of his own evolution just because you dictated it so.
Right. That's been a big learning thing of, guess what? I can't make everything better. I can't fix it. I can't control it. And I cannot create this perfect family if he does not want to be part of it.
And you've got a perfect family. You know, it's just what you're believing about your family that's not perfect. I taught my children that their father was just everything I believed him to be. And if they disagreed with me, I gave them the look at least. And then when the work found me, I just fell deeply in love with their father. And then they would say something against him, and I'd say, well, actually, I used to believe that too, and actually, I even taught you that, and actually, I don't believe it any longer. And then I would give them the opposites. In other words, the only way I was able to see him now, as caring and hardworking and devoted, and, you know, all those things. They were going, who is she talking about? You know, so they believe their father to be who I believed he was. And today, you know, they have their own minds. And they have both worlds for me, the old one and the new one. And they're discovering the new one. And so we have a very happy family.
Right. When I think about that with myself, I was encouraging my daughters to appreciate their father, because I love them so much and I didn't want them hurting, but I didn't show that same kindness to myself.
Wow.
Wow. When I think of it, because I wanted their relationship repaired.
Yeah.
But I did not, because I wanted them to have serenity. Mm-hmm. And I guess it comes back to me not loving myself enough to...
not being awake enough to him. You know, to yourself to see him.
I wanted them to see him as a good father, but I wouldn't allow myself to see him as anything but an awful husband. Mm. It's like I so wanted that for them, and I feel so happy about it. I think, you know, it's becoming a reality for them. They're seeing him in a better light, but I'm not allowing that for myself.
Wow.
Because I love them more than I love myself or whatever.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just...
Everything you're teaching them, open your mind to.
I'm really wrapped up in this suffering. I'm really a martyr about it. Right. Even if I don't carry on like it, it's internal. I'm not walking around talking about it, but that's worse probably. Because I'm still...
Well, you know, actually, it's where you've been sneaky.
That's true. I've not been presenting to the world. It's a lie. I've been presenting,
dishonest.
I'm okay. It's been just... Okay, that's Good. That's good. That's big.
Well, right out of your mouth.
It's so true. Mm-hmm. I put on this, you know, happy exterior and, you know, say these positive things. And I said, I'm so grateful this happened because I got to leave this small town I hated living in for 23 years and all this stuff. But I was I'm presenting a false self. Yeah, that's true. That's a big, really big. I'm very dishonest with everybody. In playing that it's, yeah. Yeah. That's really huge. How do I change that?
Well, I think you just did. It's a beginning.
Okay, the realization that I don't want to burdens. Well, I have to realize why I do it, I guess. Again, I think it all comes back to self-love. I don't want to hurt other people, but I'm hurting myself over and over. I don't want to hurt my daughters, but...
You're a people.
Yeah.
You don't want to hurt other people. You're a people.
That's emotional. That's hard. That's hard. The self-love. I think this whole issue is self-love.
There's only one thing harder, and that's not to.
Yes. I'm not giving myself what I need. I'm expecting it from him. But how can I expect it from him? I can't do it for myself. I'm not even showing him that I'm worthy enough. Right?
Not showing you.
Yeah, because I'm not showing me. How can I show him that I'm worthy of better treatment? I'm not allowing it for myself. I'm not allowing the serenity. So, am I on track? It feels right that it's all about self-love.
You just took your own mind back.
Okay.
There was that moment you were your own reference and you left me out of it.
It definitely is self-love that is my issue. That's my work, is self-love.
Let's look at the next one.
What do they need to do in order for me to be happy? I need Bill to be upfront and honest about his plans.
You need to be upfront and honest. Is that true? You know those people you want to be honest? You need them to be honest. Is that true? You need them to be upfront and honest. Can you absolutely know that it's true, that that's what you need? It's like, who needs God when you have your opinion? I need you to be honest, because it's all about me. You know, that's using other people to feel better about yourself. I need you to be more honest, because I am safer that way in what I believe. You need him to be more honest and upfront. Is that true? Are you sure?
No, I don't need him to be more upfront and honest. I need it to come from me, because I think I was looking for his honesty as a validation of my self-worth. And only I can give that to
myself.
I
would drop the I think.
Yeah.
That's definitely what you were doing. And how do you react? What happens to your life and your physical body and your children when you believe in your relationship with him, when you believe the thought, I need him to be upfront and honest? And he's not there yet.
Again, it attacks my thoughts, attack my self-worth. I'm not worthy of an honest relationship.
Yeah, he's not honest, and it's because of you.
It's because of me. I'm not worthy of it.
Can you imagine how, that's just like a monster ego. He's not honest because of me.
Yes, I'm not that powerful, right? That's absurd.
Nice to notice.
And I shouldn't take it personal because people tell me he's dishonest with them. So I'm not that special, I guess.
Well, I would just keep looking to my own dishonesty.
Yeah. I'm deluding myself.
So you need him to be upfront and honest. Who would you be without your story? Who would you be without that belief? Who would you be without that thought?
Lighter, freer, more at ease in the world. I wouldn't be waiting for the lies.
Wow.
I'm waiting for the next one. I'm always waiting for the next one. Even though I don't seek them out, they appear because I'm looking for them, I guess.
I would drop the I guess. You either are or you're not.
Oh, I am. I'm looking for them. I'm projecting them. I'm projecting that they're coming again and again. And, of course, then I get them.
So he walks up to the door to see the kids, for example, and you're waiting for him to lie.
Exactly.
So the man that walks up to your door is a liar.
Exactly.
So who would you be without the thought, I need him to be honest and straight up?
Just, again, freer. Stay out of what he needs to do.
Close your eyes. Okay. Look at him coming to see the kids without your story. Drop your story and just look at his eyes, his face, his body. Just look at him without your story. Really look into his eyes. Really look. What do you see?
I see a person who is showing up and that says good things. And I see also a person who has the courage to show up. So I respect that I respect him for that.
Yeah, and look what he's showing up to. I mean, someone that sees him as what you've been saying.
He's brave to show up.
A dishonest, sneaky, on and on human being at your door. He would be someone you respect that's showing up for his family.
Yeah, he's brave.
Yeah, look what he's been facing. Look what he faces when he comes to your door.
Even if it's not verbal, my body language, my demeanor.
He knows
it's not
you.
Verbal.
He knows you.
Yeah, it's not verbal.
It's you that don't know you.
Yeah, he's brave. And I respect the fact that he shows up.
So let's turn it around. And you might thank him for that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I do see it's not all bad. He's not all bad. I don't try to make it all black and white, but when I do make it black and white, I'm trying to tell myself a story to lessen my love.
Yeah, you're afraid to love him. And you love him, and there's nothing you can do about it. That, we don't have an option. That's our nature.
But I don't want to love him because it's painful.
Well, sweetheart, it's more painful not to.
I'm invested in my story because I'm trying to love him less and I want to make him bad.
You're trying to and you can't.
But if I'm still hurting, I'm not loving him less, I guess, in reality. Because then I'd be indifferent if I was loving him less. Is that
without
true?
Your story, he'd come to the door and say, you are a man I respect. You're a man that's keeping our family together. You're a man that shows up for your children. You're a man that I love with all my heart, and I really need a hug. And I apologize for boom, boom, boom. And when you do the work, you know specifically what to apologize for, and then you can even ask, how do I make it right? You know, this is how we go all the way. All the way. All the way. Not part way. All the way. You know what this does? It's like you're taking care of your past. And what this does is it gives you no past. No past. that you don't love. And so there's no past that you can project as a future other than a really beautiful one. And then you start taking that beautiful future for almost for granted. In other words, you no longer have to project it because right here, right now is heaven. And you know it's always going to be. You know it's always going to be because you understand. Because you love what you think, you love the world. And this is just an amazing beginning. This is a man you love, and these thoughts are how you try to keep yourself from the awareness of it. And that hurts you. So, you know why I love you? Because I love me.
So I should stop working on trying not to love him. That takes up a lot of my time.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because I think if I stop loving him, I will not be suffering.
And you're suffering.
Yeah, it's not working.
That's right.
So if I'm still loving him, I should just accept that.
Yes. Well, not just accept it, you know, just, yeah, accept it. You love him, there's
real.
Nothing you can do about it. And then you can start counting the blessings, like if the universe is friendly, why is your life better off without him?
I do believe the universe is benevolent. So
why is your life, why are you better off because you're not living with him?
I'm better off for this experience.
Yes.
It's waking me up to myself.
Yes, it is.
So
that's what husbands are for.
That's all I can do.
That's why they come, that's why they go.
So I need
like next. That's life.
So I really needed him to do what he did. Kind of.
Yeah, people actually are God in disguise, and you've been buying it.
It's really all here.
So can you find an example of why your life is better just waking up in the morning without him?
I'm not putting myself down for loving him. I'm not wasting the day looking for evidence that I shouldn't love him.
That's a little different than I was asking for, but that's working for you. So good. Let's look at the next one.
So number 5, what do you think of them? Make a list. Well, it all sounds a little bit absurd now.
You know when people change, when you question what you believe about them? That's when they change. You want them to change, look to yourself.
Yeah, it's absurd.
So Bill is?
Sneaky, dishonest, shallow. Concerned with appearances and how things look. Help me with that one. I'm serious.
You help you with that one. Concerned as a parent.
Concerned with appearances and how things look.
Yeah.
The sneaky and dishonest I get, okay.
Look how you are with your children. Remember the sneaky, dishonest part that you discovered?
Remind me.
Well, you were saying things like you put up a front with your children, like you don't want them to see him as a bad father. You want them to see him as a wonderful father, but you haven't been giving you that.
So that's the appearances, right? Okay. I want to keep up appearances, and I want... I'm concerned with the appearance that he is the perfect father to them. And I'm sure they're feeling... that even though I'm saying that verbally, I'm sure they're perceptive to the fact that I don't feel that way about him.
Yeah, they're very clear about that.
Yeah, yeah.
They're so clear about that.
Yeah. I'm saying it, but I'm not living it. It's just...
You're trying to bring them into your little thing you have set up here.
Because I have to fix their little world.
So let's turn it around. I am.
Okay, I am sneaky, dishonest, and shallow because I'm concerned with the appearance that everything, the looks of everything, and how things look to my children. And I want it to look, I don't want it to look dysfunctional. I want him to appear to be almost an unrealistic view.
I dropped the almost.
Okay. I want to see, I still want them to see him as a male without faults, as a father.
Okay, so you want them to see him as a man without faults. So turn it around, I want me to see him.
Well, I know I need to see him for who he really is.
Yeah, he's a man without faults. You know, the faults are in your opinion.
Yes.
They weren't there before your opinion changed. In other words, what you were believing about him. So read that list again. He is, Bill is.
The same one, sneaky, dishonest.
What's the opposite of sneaky?
Forthcoming.
And dishonest, the opposite?
Truthful.
Okay, so where is he forthcoming and truthful?
He's consistent in who he is.
Wow.
He's very consistent.
Wow, you may
want... So he's very truthful.
You may want to share that with him and thank him for that. Where else is he... forthcoming and honest, truthful?
Okay.
Where was he forthcoming and truthful about his affair?
Well, that I'm having a problem with.
When was he forthcoming and truthful about his affair?
Well, it took him a long time when confronted, but I guess eventually...
Don't guess. He eventually...
Admitted it.
Okay, so now drop the eventually.
So he admitted it, so he was honest.
Feel that. He admitted it. He gave you everything you wanted, it's just that you missed it. You wanted him to be forthcoming and honest, and he was.
I wanted him to be it before he was ready. That feels really true. I wanted it when I wanted it. When I wanted my healing.
Well, you know, what you wanted, he gave you. Which is a wonderful thing to experience. You can see that they give you what you want, and it's still, that's not it. For you to be forthcoming and honest with him, letting him know how you appreciate how honest and forthcoming he was, and you don't have to say eventually. He was.
That's true. He was. He did it.
Yes, he did.
So he did give me that.
He did.
But why did I
well, you
feel
you.
I had to work for it? Or, I don't know. Mm-hmm. But would have it have come eventually?
You got what you wanted.
So
look what you're doing. You're doing a dance around the very thing you wanted from the very beginning in this worksheet.
Say that again.
What you wanted, he gave you.
Because he gave me myself. He gave me an opportunity to look at myself.
Well, that is happening.
Yeah. He gave me the truth of...
He also gave you... He was forthright and honest about his affair. Let's look at the next one.
What is it that you don't want to experience with that person again? I don't want to ever feel unloved or abandoned.
He doesn't love you. Is that true?
I can't be certain of it.
He doesn't love you. Can you absolutely know that it's true he doesn't love
you? No, I can't know that for certain.
And how do you react when you... think the thought, he doesn't love me. What happens?
I feel unworthy. I feel that abandoned feeling. I feel bad about myself.
And who would you be without the thought, he doesn't love me, when he came to the door? or called on the phone, who would you be without the thought he doesn't love me?
Lighter, like I left a heavy load. Freer.
And happy to hear his voice.
Yes.
The father of your children. This man that you love.
Again, it all comes back to I have to stop working on unloving him. I guess.
So let's stay with the work. Okay. So,
could I say that statement again? I don't ever want to feel unloved or abandoned again.
So he doesn't love me, turn it around.
I don't love me. That's very apparent.
Okay, so you know you have to project onto him what you see in yourself. Can you find another turnaround? He doesn't love me.
I don't love me.
He doesn't love me. Try he does.
Oh, that's obvious. He does love me.
So give me an example of how that is as true or truer.
Because he is taking care of us financially.
He doesn't have to do that.
No, to a certain extent, but not to the extent that he does.
Yes.
Nobody's forcing him to.
Yes.
He's never not done it. I didn't have to do the court thing.
Well.
That's big.
Well.
So I should not feel unloved. Because he's probably just, he is giving me exactly what he can. It's not what my story requires.
And you don't even have to do his laundry.
I have thought of that. And I don't have to make huge meals that he likes.
This man is a bonus. And you're complaining.
I have thought of the laundry and the no work, whatever. The meals that I know he liked.
And who did he have the affair with? You know, she gets that and you get the money.
Yes. So far, yes.
And his beautiful children.
Yes.
This man is a saint.
I'm so lucky.